Hi, it's Glenda Hopp again from So Many Colors. In this video, we're going to talk about overdyeing. If you're looking for hand-dyed fabric for quilts or other projects, you might often run across the term overdyeing. That simply means fabric that has been dyed one color and has been put through a second dye bath of a different color. Now, typically you get your best results with overdyeing if you use colors that are adjacent to each other on the color wheel. So overdyeing a blue with a red will give you shades of purple. Overdyeing a red with yellow will give you shades of orange. Today I'm going to show you several different fabrics overdyed with a pure solution of fuchsia dye. Fuchsia is one of the primary dyes in the red, blue, yellow grouping. It is not a mixture of other colors. It's a pure color. For our overdyeing experiment, I'm first going to use the fabric that we dyed in brilliant blue in my first video. A little bit drab, adding the fuchsia dye to this should give us lovely shades of purple and violet. I'm then going to try to rescue this fabric, don't know if it's going to work, a really odd greenish gray color, not happy with this example at all. The next fabric is an experiment gone terribly wrong. I can't use this fabric because it's just plain ugly. So I'm going to try overdyeing it with fuchsia and see if we can rescue it. And then finally, I'll use just some pure white fabric to show you the pure fuchsia without any dye under it. I'm going to crumple these fabrics up very tightly in my small container. Again, I'm working with the 100% cotton interlock from Dharma Trading. I love this fabric. It has such a nice soft feel. And I'm going to very tightly wrinkle and crumple the fabric into my small container. This should give us a lot of variation in color because the dye can't penetrate the wrinkles as evenly as in a loose configuration, so we should end up with a lot of texture and color. I'm going to repeat this crinkling process, scrunching process, with the rest of our fabrics, and then come back and add the dye. I have almost all of the fabric tucked in. I have pretty close to 5 yards of fabric here, and this is a very small container. So it's very tightly packed. Try to get a lot of wrinkles and folds in the fabric. And I think we're just about ready to go. Here you see all four of our fabrics. Crinkled up, ready to dye. Time for rubber gloves and the dye. I've pre-mixed the fuchsia dye in a fairly strong concentration in about a gallon of water. And using an old liquid dish soap container makes it very easy to pour onto the fabric. Not going to worry too much about where the dye goes. A gallon will not be too much dye for this amount of fabric. And we do want a very mottled look. So if we filled it up quite full so that the fabric almost floated in the water, we'd end up with a lot more solid looking fabric, even though we have the crinkles. I'm going to smoosh the fabric down just a bit, add the rest of the dye, perfect. Here's our fabric with the dye. Again, we'll let it set. Now this time I did not add the soda ash to the dye solution. I'm going to add that in 15 or 20 minutes. Just a different technique for adding soda ash to fix the color permanently to the fiber. Show you what the fabric looks like when it's done. Fabric's been sitting in the dye solution for about 20 minutes. I've mixed up a little more than half a gallon of water with about 6 tablespoons of soda ash and simply poured it into the same container I used to pour the dye. I'm going to pour this over the fabric. And because the soda ash needs to penetrate everywhere the dye is going to be fixed, I'm also going to gently lift up the corners of the fabric, add some soda ash solution in the bottom. Don't want to disturb the crumples too much. Pour the remaining soda ash solution over the fabric. Another hour, and I'll be able to rinse and wash and dry the fabric and show you the results. I'm back with the results of our overdye experiment. If you remember, we worked with a fuchsia, and this is an example of the fuchsia over the white fabric. It's a really pretty color. We have some white and light pink showing. We then had a brilliant blue, which was this shade, but quite a bit more solid. And this is the result. We have a lot more texture and interest, a little bit of the blue showing through, but quite a bit of purple and violet as well. I was quite surprised at how well that funny green turned out. It was a light green with a little bit of gray, but it has turned out quite nice. You have a little more subtle coloring, not quite as bright in the red tones and the purple tones as the overdye of the brilliant blue, but nonetheless, quite a nice color combination. What surprised me the most was that really awful fabric. The one with all the blobs of color on it. This turned out far beyond my expectations. Those blobs of fabric have contributed to sort of a stripy look. Very happy with this, and I think I'm going to try this intentionally on other fabrics. So try overdyeing. It not only can rescue a really bad dye job, it can also add a lot of interest and layers of colors which provide texture. Next time, we'll talk about the importance of soda ash and different ways you can add soda ash to your dye batch. Thanks for watching.